Wafa talking about, it's not just about providing you the technology and walking away. It's 1,000 per month. It's, we can see the huge...
...want you and ICU to actually support the critical care of a patient. So what the government does, and Kenya does no differently, is to make sure that the ICUs, which are currently being equipped and being positioned around the country, are in the formerly provincial hospitals, so the level 5 hospitals. So basically where all the advanced services or referral hospitals be taken. So from a district level, level 4 or level 3, in case there is a critical ill patient, and that could be due to an accident, that could be due to another critical disease, those kind of things, he or she needs to be transferred to a critical care area. Now, initially, all those patients had to travel long distances to come to Nairobi or MTRH or maybe Mombasa. Now, all those critical care areas are much closer. Yeah? They are now equipped in all those hospitals. And what it takes, actually, is to really have a semi-sterile environment, create a semi-sterile environment. You need to have oxygen. So what we provided over there is first of all a very high-end environment in an ICU, and you'll see some pictures later on as well. We renovated the existing buildings in such a way that the building itself will be fully up to standard as an international ICU environment. Easy to clean, hygiene, this kind of thing as well. Access control is important, so that people cannot just walk and enter an ICU, because otherwise you'll infect the patients, or patients can infect others as well. So very important to control access. And then, of course, to provide the oxygen, the air, the compression, etc., to make sure that the equipment which is needed to stabilize the patient, or to even to give oxygen to the patient, is been there. So the older infrastructure, what we call it a medical gas plant, has been built. So the medical gas plant provides compressed air, it provides oxygen, and what we provide there is an oxygen concentrator. Yeah, so in the past, hospitals had to buy bottles from a central place in Nairobi. The bottles with oxygen will be transported to the hospital, and if they're empty, they have to buy new ones. Very expensive exercise.
We asked, and we work with the military in the US, we work with the military in Germany, and they asked, and we told them about the Lumify, and they were very excited. But I think it's important to realize that I think the delivery of health services is not so much about putting a product on the table and saying, here's a product. It's a fantastic product. Annelie is going to do it because it's really a fantastic product. And we're very proud, and we hope that a lot of people will use it. But it's much more of understanding, hey, what are the needs? And indeed, this is a device that can be basically put in a backpack. It's very small, it's very light. And again, if you think military, you can have very dangerous situations where you can have casualties. And if you then do a very good, on-the-spot analysis of what the issues are, that can help a lot in how to stabilize the patients and to get them maybe to a field hospital or even further. So yes, we told them, we mentioned it, we even invited them this evening, and maybe they will come. But for sure they're interested in the product. But it's very important to understand, how do you use it? How do you equip the people? So the product is very important, but having the discussion on saying, okay, so what is the purpose? What do you want to achieve? Because you also need to see it a little bit as a business. You want to drive a result. You want to drive an outcome. And if it's just to have a nice gadget, I don't think, adding long-term to the development of healthcare. Well, if you have a discussion about how can it really bring a benefit, who's going to use it, and what are the clinical outcomes, how many lives can you save, then you can have a good discussion. And we started that discussion this morning.